from any perspective is always breathtaking. Prince Edward Island, Canada's Atlantic jewel. It's a summer playground with nothing to block out the sky. A bountiful, magnificent island, inviting all visitors to safe harbor and a share of good fortune. Four craftsmen have ventured to this isle, led by Mark O'Meara, newly crowned British Open champion, following a surge to victory at the Masters, rejuvenated at 41. Long-hitting John Daly, the leading driver on the tour, averaging nearly 300 yards each swing. A winner of the PGA Championship and the Open. Incredible how he crushes the ball. Sweet-swinging Mike Weir from Brights Grove, Ontario's here. One of three Canadians on the PGA Tour and the 1997 Canadian Order of Merit champion. Weir, a rising star. And Mr. Skins himself, Fred Couples. Another big hitter, Boom Boom Couples has been on target for $750,000 en route to three Export A Skins titles. Before them stands the Lynx at Crowbush Cove, celebrating its fifth season. The seaside course uses the natural contours as its greatest asset. It's time to tee it up for the sixth Export A Skins game. For 6 years now, the finest golfers in the game have been coming to Canada to share their abilities and their insights, and this season, it's no exception. Four of the finest in all of the sport have come to beautiful Prince Edward Island, convening here to make some new friends and hopefully make a lot of money. $360,000 up for grabs at the Lynx at Crowbush Cove, and as you can see, just a gentle breeze for the seaside rendezvous. There was some discussion that this 6,900-yard layout, par 72, would be awfully fierce if the wind was, but she's not. Spectacular sunshine as we welcome you to the sixth annual Export A Skins Game. Rod McLean and Jim Nelford, and we just saw when the pros were out practicing, the great reaction to the golfers. And I think, you know, for you watching at home, we have 5,000 who are here for the gallery. That's all you can fit around a foursome as grand as this. And you really sense people know that they're walking with something special. Hottest golfer on the planet, coolest guy in the game, biggest hitter, and a homegrown hero. Jim, what excites you the most about Mark O'Meara coming off the Open victory?
Well, you know, two majors in a row. Here's the guy on a streak. He could win three. This is probably the best golf he's ever played in his life. And for us to be able to watch every shot he hits for 18 holes against the guys he's playing against, it's fabulous. You know, he may be the shortest hitter of the group, but when he gets that putter out, it's magic.
There's been a lot of magic in golf over the last couple of seasons with Ben Crenshaw and Davis Love. And when you see the guy that was supposed to be the mentor to Tiger Woods suddenly turn around after Woods wins a Masters at that young age and win two majors. I mean, a 41-year-old's given us all a little faith, hasn't he?
He certainly has. You know, Tiger Woods kind of put the challenge on Mark. You know, he kind of says, we're coming up here, we're the young guys, we're going to knock all you guys off. And Mark said, no, we're not ready to let go of that yet. You know, I think we're still going to carry this torch for a little while. And it brought his game up to a totally different level. And a Mark O'Meara, I think that a lot of us expected to see a little earlier, but better late than never.
A lot of these spruce trees here on the first hole lost their needles just at the sight of John Daly. So what about the biggest hitter in the game?
Oh, John Daly, so exciting to have in a Skins game. You never know where his ball's going to come down. It can come down anywhere. He may drive a couple of these par fours or get very close anyways. He's so explosive. Not only does he hit at 9 miles, but he's got great touch around the greens. A lot of these greens are elevated, so he'll hit a lot of flop shots. It'll be fun to watch, too.
Don Cherry kind of guy. There's no doubt about that. And Mike Weir from Brights Grove, Ontario, is 28 years old, first year on the PGA Tour, and you flew in from Utah with him. You never meet a nicer fellow or more talented kid, I don't think.
No, I think he's Canada's real hope, the next guy that can come out and really play well. You know, last round at Mississippi, he just shot 65. He made about 8 or 9 birdies. And his last few practice rounds, he's been on a big streak. So it's a really exciting tournament for Mike because this could be his breakthrough time. You know, he gets to play against major winners and put his game up against them. If he gets in there and makes 5 or 6 birdies and steals some money, this may be the event that propels Mike to where he wants to be on the PGA Tour.
And, you know, you can sense Mark O'Meara was really good on the practice tee, making him loose. I don't think he'd be nervous anyway in a fun event like this, but all the same, this is pretty select company, and he was sharing his pro card with the caddy, Jerry. So there's a lot of little magic, and it gets even better with Fred Couples, who's always our favorite.
You know, I think Freddie has almost reached Arnold Palmer status as probably the most fun guy to watch in golf. I love watching this guy play golf. It's so elegant. It's so powerful and great touch around the greens. He's just a neat guy to watch and king of the skins games.
Well, this is the home of the greatest potatoes in the world, and skins games are always popular here, but we got a new slant on it, and you're going to see that as we give these great golfers a nice PEI welcome. Mark O'Meara, nice round of applause for the foursome, and I don't have to tell you, Mark, there's a huge thrill for all golf fans in Canada to have the winner of the Masters and most recently the Open. Have you worked for it, but have your feet touched the ground all the same with the success?
Well, I think it's still sinking in. It was so much fun last week. What a great championship that is, and to be able to play so well at Birkdale on a very difficult course and difficult conditions and come out on top, something I'll remember for the rest of my life. So it's nice to be back in Canada. A lot of great people have come out to watch today, some four fine players, and hopefully we'll give them a good show. Beautiful day, great place to be, and we're excited about getting it started.
You gave us some fun on the practice tee alone. Good luck today.
Thanks.
First nine holes for Mark O'Meara coming up here in just a moment. Let's tell you about Mike Weir, the chap who was hitting balls right beside him, a lefty and a righty, side-by-side on the practice tee a moment ago. Mike Weir from Brights Grove, Ontario, 28 years old, last year's Canada's Order of Merit champion, won his card at Q School, and there's his beautiful wife, Brescia, and their daughter, Elle. And Mike said, never mind playing with Mark O'Meara, John Daly, and Fred Couples. Nervous is when you're at Q School and you're expecting your child. And he got through that magnificently, as he does seemingly everything. I asked him, what's a perfect day of golf other than your business of the sport? He said, to play with my dad and my two brothers back at Brights Grove. So he's really excited to be in this company, as we say. Here's how it breaks down. Holes 1 through 6 will play the front nine tonight, back nine tomorrow. First six holes, $15,000 per hole. Two tie, you all tie, so you have to win the hole outright to grab the skin. 7 through 12 is worth $20,000 apiece, and the final six holes, $25,000, for a total purse of $360,000, and nobody knows better how to carve that up than Freddie Couples. We'll begin, as we say, on the front nine, the first four or five holes through the beautiful spruce trees, then we move into the marshland, and then over onto the Gulf of St. Lawrence. Hole number one, par four, 408 yards, Jim Nelford.
A very good starting hole, just a slight dogleg right with woods on the right side of the fairway and two bunkers on the left side, about 280 yards from the tee. Players, if they drive in the fairway, probably have 8 or 9 iron left to one of the very few greens that isn't guarded by water or bunkers. Today the pin will be cut back right. We should see a birdie here today.
Official introductions of the foursome. Let's go now to Steve Armitage.
Hello and welcome on behalf of Export A to the links at Crowbush Cove and the 6th annual Export A Skins Game. I'm Steve Armitage. For our fans at the course, and the television audience in Canada and around the world, I'd like to introduce our four fine players. Out of Windermere, Florida, and fresh from a playoff victory at the 1998 British Open, his second major of the season following the Masters, a man with 16 PGA Tour wins, Mark O'Meara.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Stop it.
Never stop.
Did you ever change?
Huh?
Where it goes, Joe?
From Rogers, Arkansas, the leader in driving distance on the PGA Tour and a winner of two majors, the 91 PGA and the 95 British Open, here is John Daly.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Shot.
A fairway. Huh?
From Dallas, Texas, a winner of 14 PGA Tour events, including the 1992 Masters, and a three-time champion of the Export A Skins game, Fred Couples.
Yep.
And originally from Sarnia and Brights Grove, Ontario, now making his home in Draper, Utah, the 1997 Canadian Masters champion and Order of Merit leader, now playing on the PGA Tour, the left-hander, Mike Weir.
Are off and running. We'll continue our coverage of hole number one, the 1998 Export A Skins game from beautiful links at Crowbush Cove in a moment.
The Export A Skins game on CBC. Brought to you by NEC Technologies. Expect more. Experience more. By Sprint Canada. Get the most for your business from Sprint Canada.
Welcome back to the Export A Skins game from Crowbush Cove in beautiful Prince Edward Island. And Mike Weir, Jim, fourth to hit. Not an easy act to follow, but he did it.
Not after those three drives. Absolutely three perfect drives. Mike pushed his tee shot just a little bit into the light rough. 135 yards to the flag. Hit the cut back right. This will be a little 9-iron that he hopes doesn't get away and fly on him.
Come a little right. Might take a little sting out of it, maybe.
Good.
Yeah. had it right on line, but it didn't jump like he expected it to, but it was tracking all the way. Didn't quite make it up the ridge.
Ball's going to spin like
84. O'Meara now, little 9-iron, 130. Good indication of how soft the greens are and how they're holding.
Yeah.
Guys will be able to fly it right at the hole today. Hardly a breath of wind right now. Freddie Couples, just a little over 300 yards on the tee shot. Got to have a sand wedge here.
Get up.
Okay, Freddie.
Thanks.
Long John with 97 yards to the hole. May even have this L wedge.
Get up. Is that up
a little bit?
You sand it? We're on the club all week.
In the garage?
Fred Couples asking Joe LeCava's caddy where the clubs have been stored. Has he still got for the last 8 years?
Take care of him?
He owns links, but he never gives himself a new set.
Well, when you get used to a certain field.
You play with golf? You can play with Hawk?
Jeff Russell.
God. Oh, Rosa Fort.
I thought Atlanta was.
I don't like him much.
I thought you liked him.
You know.
No?
You can see Freddie's uptight once again in this game's game.
I don't like him as well.
Can't relax.
Look at these balls. Hey, well, I got a crack out of here, boys. All right, you read them, because I'm...
I finally figured it out
that I can't read these
Pretty
things.
Good one.
To finish our thought, you get a set of clubs that you play well with. You know how far you hit them. You know all the shafts. All the lofts, and you really don't want to switch.
You got any connections?
Mark O'Meara is 41 years old.
I bet you are.
Really young at heart. He's taking Tiger Woods to see Van Halen in concert in Atlanta next weekend.
I don't blame him.
And he's up to Park City, Utah to check out ski condos, and then he might put his mind back at winning the third major up in Seattle.
For different reasons, right?
Yeah.
He enjoys his time away from the golf course.
Yeah. Shot there, Freddie.
Thank you. Fred. Start us off with a bang.
All right, man.
It can happen.
Mark O'Meara away. You'll see him with the same routine. Two practice strokes, two glances at the hole, then he knocks it in.
Crowd early.
That's usually the result.
Soccer man, chicken. Here we go. So, it'll get ugly.
And if Mark is away, Mike Weir is going to be upset about it. He's got this all lined up. What do you see? Right
center. Almost straight up the hill. Right over the ridge, about 5 feet in front of Mike.
I'm going to get checked. Look out!
Come on, Mike. Nice try.
Good solid stroke and a good start for Mike.
Oh, that's good, Mike. Pick it up, Buff.
Get close, Mark.
Okay, John.
We're now from about 25 feet or so up over the ridge.
There was a second look, and now he butts.
Kicked off that ridge a little bit right on Mark.
You got a pretty right at it.
Me too?
Thanks for the read, by the way.
That's good.
I thought I was going to go back to the left on top.
Huh?
I thought I
was going to go back to the left on top.
Only Mike Weir has seen the course, by the way. The other guys just thought they'd come and have a bit of fun and take some chances.
There you go, Don.
I think you got that totally wrong.
Huh?
That's I think right. You meant to play it down like this. Right, Fred? Nice putt.
Thanks.
You go, Freddy. You want some help on that, partner?
Right edge? That was moving, wasn't it? More.
More left.
Sure. Most of John Daly's putts are moving when they get to the hole. Beautiful flowing putting stroke. Talk about great putting strokes. Here's one. He's got it on the right edge.
Birdie didn't want him to have that 15,000 easily.
You get a car
John Daly is first to draw blood in his first appearance at a Skins game in Canada. You can see John nestling up to Steve Armitage. Steve.
Thank you, Ron. And John wanted to know if he got a car with the first Skins game. No, you only get $15,000.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll take it. That's good. It's always good to get on the board. You know, I didn't expect to get on it this quick, but the last Skins game I played was in the States, and I got nailed, so... You know, it's good to get on the board.
Did you get a good read on Mark's putt?
Not really. I did find out it did break right, though, so that helped, and I just hit it firm.
Quick thought on what you're expecting out here at Crowbush.
Well, so far, so good. You know, it'd be nice to have all of it, but no, it's just going to be. It's a lot of fun.
Congratulations on the first skin. Good luck.
Thanks.
Ron, back to you.
John Daly figured it's automatic. 49th in earnings with $389,174 so far in 1998 and $15,000 here this evening at Crowbush. We'll continue our coverage of the Export A Skins game.
The Export A Skins game on CBC. Brought to you by BMW, the ultimate driving experience. By Callaway Golf, how golf should feel. And by Investors Group, Canada's leading personal financial services company with offices from coast to coast.
The links at Crowbush Cove, I don't have to tell you, we're in Laurie Kane country, Canada's sensational female golfer. And Laurie's dad, Jack, manages the course here. See John off to this quick start as we move to the second hole. And Jim, you can tell us all about it.
Well, second hole is going to be an exciting little hole. We'll see where these guys can drive it. Only 366 yards, so that cluster of bunkers right there is really not in play for the guys, although it certainly looks at that way from the tee. Very intimidating. You can't tell the bunker through the fairway is not part of this cluster. But right at this point is only 208 yards. Players will probably drive it out in this area. Now Long John may actually get it to this bunker right in front of the green right here. So he'll have to play away from that. From this point, the guys will just have sand wedges or L wedges. Over the ridge in the middle of this green, in the back part of the green, slopes away from the players, and the pin today is right there.
John Daly's led the PGA in driving 7 of the last 8 seasons.
Watch this rip.
Nope. Other cut.
Ooh. Right through the gallery and into the trees left.
Supposed to hit it the other way, right?
Solid, Johnny.
That's all that matters, right? Hit it solid.
Nice cut.
Mark O'Meara now is going to hit it right over the bunkers right there.
Kept your company, JD.
Well, he got it
right to left.
He's got it going left, too.
Get hit right over the bunker.
Not quite far enough to get any trouble.
You know, it's a funny hole. Mike Weir does have the advantage here because it really looks like the hole plays longer to the left of those bunkers, and that's the way you're supposed to be pointed. But in reality, you've got to take it right over the bunkers on the right and actually hug the right side of the fairway.
Beauty, Frank. There you go. Good shot. Awesome, man.
I'll take it.
Just on.
That's pretty cool already.
It sets up perfectly for Mike Weir. Likes to draw it off the tee.
What are we doing?
Man, that's
fine, huh? A little bit too much.
That's good, huh?
Into the rough, yeah. But opens up that pin a little.
One of the many fans here for the Pro-Am is Lloyd Eisler, a great figure skater from Seaforth, Ontario. And when Mike Weir was 13 years old, he won his first ever tournament. He'd never broken 80, fired a 69 to capture a junior event in Seaforth. There's Freddie Couples. And in the course of our telecasts, tonight and tomorrow, we want to catch up on some of the finest shots ever made by the four pros here. And let's begin with Boom Boom.
Well, here's a young and agile Freddie Couples doing what he does best. Launching a fairway wood to a par five. And how many shots have we seen like that? And this, the famous shot at the President's Cup on the last hole. Towering six iron out of a bunker, and watch this one. And that to secure a point for the American side.
Get in there.
1992 Masters champion. And as you've often said, he's got the one major, but in effect he's got three because he's captured two TPCs.
Yeah, this is the 17th hole at the TPC. Perfect tee shot right off that ridge. And, well, all right.
Feet never leave the ground.
And this, the perfect three iron.
Oh, baby. Hit up a little tee right.
At the Masters this year on the 13th hole. As good as it can be done. Freddie Couples.
Obviously, Royal Montreal brought the best. I think Steve Jones and Norman went at it.
Yeah, got a good angle.
But it's hard to go for 1 year.
I'm looking so forward to
get, you know, play a course and get used to it, and then
you guys want
to go back. I mean, that's, you know, some
play
people say, well, why? Well,
of course,
what if you go and play well?
I mean,
you know, you don't go back ever. It's kind of.
And then, of course, the complaint from people in Canada is, why do you only have the one course?
Welcome
well,
to Jeffrey
sure.
Goodman.
And, you know,
this group, Goodman Communications, helps run this event. And I don't think there's any question. One of the attractive aspects of the Export A Skins game has been the ability to take it around the country. We know what a thrill it was for BC last year, and you can only imagine the excitement in the Maritimes.
You and I build a course. You know, we may never get one, so you don't really build them. You don't set the cables, you don't set the mounds, and you don't spend a lot of extra money to do that.
Anybody
in the
dead?
States, you and I would say, you know, we're going to
turn
to St. Louis.
There's Mike.
Well, I'm used to this.
And I was saying at 13 years of age, he won the Seaforth Junior Invitational with a 69, and it was at that point his dad said, you know, we ought to really pursue a U.S. college scholarship opportunity, and they figured it'd be a good idea to follow in your footsteps, Jim.
Well, he went to a great university, Brigham Young, followed both Richard Zokel, myself, and Brent Franklin down there. Carl Tucker, coach down there, runs a great program, very competitive, and Mike was a big part of that team when he played, and gained a lot of valuable experience.
How many players would Brigham bring in for their golf program?
Well, we had 12 guys who played on the team. And so you fight for six traveling spots, and Mike was on the team right from the start. And so
step back, it's right along with the pin there.
Carl Tucker found that he could go mine the gold up in Canada and see, bring the good players out of Canada.
Thanks.
He probably had the best Canadian players coming out of Brigham Young.
When he was 16, he won the Canadian Juvenile at Windermere in Edmonton. He was one of four Ontarians to qualify, and Ontario Golf Association sent the juniors up to Alberta. He was there with a good friend of his, Brennan Little. And Brennan ultimately introduced him to his teacher now, Mike Wilson. So Brennan, if you're watching, you can take a little pride in the great day we're having here.
Ball could go anywhere.
118 yards out of the rough for Mike. Oh, and a little unlucky that didn't release a little more. That was right on it. But a good shot, puts the pressure on the other guys.
Mark O'Meara will have 110 yards.
But I'm hitting it from over here.
That was a little pitching wedge from O'Meara. And that is long.
What?
Over the green.
Right in the middle of your backswing, they're over here giggling.
No, that's all right.
No, that's not all right. We'll get him.
Back further.
Another 5 feet. I catch the sign back there?
There's no telling where this ball was going.
Mark, by the way, hasn't played. He played nine holes on Friday with Tiger Woods and a doctor friend of theirs. And that's all he's played since the Open victory.
Oh, my shot.
Well, he's got so many good memories.
I'm always ready.
Watching him on the practice tee is just dead pure.
Somewhere up there, huh?
The game is looking easy for Mark.
I see a tree moving in there.
Oh. That's it. Where that could go.
Okay.
Well, he's
two ties.
What's the total,
They're banking on Fred Couples to help him out here today.
Sure.
Well, Freddie with a little lob wedge from 80 yards. Just throw it up there nice and soft. And
go. I'm yelling go.
I'm sure that did it.
Shouldn't have passed up that practice round, Freddie.
It's been a good year for Fred. Two victories, Memorial and the Bob Hope Classic. And a tied for second at the Masters. So Weir and Couples in the best position to take 15,000 here at hole number two. We'll continue our coverage exclusively on CBC Sports from the links at Crowbush Cove.
Oh my God.
Back greenside here at the second hole at Crowbush. As you know, Mark O'Meara went along with
What shade are you doing over there?
Pitch. John's picked up, Mark.
Okay. I didn't know.
I'm a paying customer right now.
Well, you got 15 grand to watch already, so.
O'Meara's ball was under our tower there, so he got a free drop. Now a little flop shot from behind the green.
Might want to pick that up, Mark.
Did he go by Mike, or will he get to show Mike the line?
I couldn't tell. I think he did. So he's right on Mike's
line. Yeah, there he is.
Line.
He's by it. Yeah.
Yeah, please.
And there's Mike moving his mark, so. Mm-hmm. Advantage Mike Weir. And if there's any defense in golf, Freddie's going to play it right now. See if he can make birdie. He figures that after Mike has a look at Mark's putt,
pop right up in the air.
Got a good chance to make it.
I hate to spoil a good story because potentially we'll show it to you. We interviewed Fred last night, but he mentioned when Mark O'Meara made the 20-footer to win the Masters, Freddie was over at his bag with Joe LaCava's caddy, and he took out the towel and wiped his putter, and he said, Joe, we're in trouble here. You knew O'Meara was running it in.
Oh.
Tough out of that.
Yeah, he was a little worried about that, the way the ball was going to come out of the plane. You see, use the pop stroke, but never
Pick
was
it up.
Online.
Hey, I tell you what, we could cut a little deal here. I could, you know, show you the line for about $5,000. For about $5,000, I'd be more than happy, Mike. You can stand right about here.
Hey, Mark.
Watch if you want.
Hey, Mark.
How do you feel over that?
Hey, friend? Mark.
I like it.
Mark.
Only on the senior tour they do that.
Referring to the famous purse splitting a few years ago. I don't think that was his best effort, John.
No, that's that's being a
you
team
get a
player.
Good read on that one, Mike. Oh,
yeah.
Mark, that was cool, man.
I just slightly. You see, I have a little rotation at the top.
That was good. I'd hit myself if I tried that.
I thought you were my friend.
Yeah.
What war out here?
What a.
No, I'll knock it in there.
This is not the time to.
Yeah, mention. You mean that.
I do.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do I do.
Not the time to mention Hank Haney, Mark's instructor.
Now this putt should break a little bit to Mike's left, a little bit to our right, just outside the hole.
No! No!
Good try. That was a good
Freddie,
try.
Can you make that?
You know.
It's a little more speed.
Yeah, huh? More speed.
I hope.
It's good by me and all the other guys.
That's good.
Well, let's see if Freddie's in the giving mode.
Thanks, buddy.
Good yeah. Putt, Freddie. All right, Freddie.
I don't think they still found my ball there.
I'd still like to know how his ball is going to roll down the hill.
Yeah.
That's rough, too.
Yeah, they're rough.
Well, especially with Wilson
yeah.
clubs. Mine never bit like that.
So then, with the tie, it'll be a carryover to the third hole, 15,000, coupled with 15,000 that was available on hole number three. They'll play for $30,000 here on hole number three.
Third hole is a very reachable par three, Ron, and I think every one of the players will be able to get there in two today. See a slight dogleg right, that cluster of bunkers again residing on the right side of the fairway. We'll push Mike Weir and Mark O'Meara to the left, but right at this point, 284 yards to carry those bunkers, and I think couples, John Daly will challenge that. From that point in, from the back of those bunkers is about 215 yards. These bunkers right here, right in front of us, are not in play, but they do obscure the view of the green. And the green slopes from front to back, very narrow at the front, guarded by this one bunker. The pin today is cut right here. Very accessible, Macy and Eagle.
Well, you see a few clouds building. So far, the wind is not an
really?
Issue.
Really? You guys are up? Okay.
Yesterday afternoon at about 5 o'clock Atlantic, there was a good rainstorm, and by the looks of that cloud formation, later today, it wouldn't be an issue. We're actually teeing off at 9:30 in the morning, and then, of course, bringing it to you prime time off the tape.
Not left again.
Can we just keep it in the same order as always do?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, baby. Oh.
Well, Daly did right, not John, need to go left there.
No cut, man. Good swing.
Good view from behind the player, what they're looking at. Mark has to keep it left of those bunkers. He has no chance of flying it over.
Good job, Mark.
Never saw it.
Perfect.
Yeah.
It's got to get old.
Not far, but straight.
It's got to get old.
240-yard shot.
Just let me know what it feels like to hit out of that short grass, will you?
Let me know how that 15,000 feels in your pocket.
We'll see if Freddie's back is loose enough for him to take a rip at it here.
As loose as Freddie can be, I think John's got him today.
Viagra. Keep an eye on her.
That one-liner compliments to John Daly. He's up for the event here. We'll continue our coverage on hole number three, worth $30,000. Links at Crowbush Cove, setting for the 1998 Export A Skins Game. The Export A Skins Game presented by NEC. Sixth year in a row, we've gathered four great golfers in Canada. We're on Prince Edward Island, and 15,000 to John Daly, the lone skin thus far. And Steve Armitage, we see the clouds building. How about the wind?
Well, we had hoped the wind would roar and make this course a bit of a tiger. It has picked up just a little bit on this third hole. It's going to favor them. Definitely reachable.
You told us in the break it was a gentle zephyr. And that'll make Mark O'Meara happy because he's a touch over. But he, as you know, is a five-time winner at Pebble Beach. He likes it.
Oh, that's it. Playing it. What we got there? Now, easy, baby.
Mark O'Meara had 225 yards, and he was
got
trying
him right
to
in the crotch.
Cut a three-wood in there and just overcooked it. Right in between clubs. He has one iron in his bag, but I don't think he could reach it with that.
The perfect position here. That's fun.
Not a short drive by any means. O'Meara hit it 275. Mike Weir got it down the hill, 284 from the tee, and 216 left. He took the two iron out of the bag, and that probably would have been the club, but this five wood is going to have to launch up in the air, right over the bunkers, the two bunkers right in front of the green. Kind of guard the pin. He's got the ball on the downslope, so difficult shot.
A little skin climb.
Not a bad place to be, chipping back up the throw to the green.
When we get a moment, I'd like to find out what he feels the state of his swing is. I know he mentioned to me yesterday the one thing he always reminds himself of is his alignment. That's the thing that he and Mike have been working on, Mike Wilson, his teacher.
Yeah.
I don't think Freddie can work on this swing, can he?
You like this at all?
Oh, it's so flowing. You know, he doesn't think about it. He just feels it. Couples 215 with a 3-iron. He will launch this in the air.
Started to turn and then went
to five wood.
I didn't hit it very good. Well, I mean,
yeah.
Should have just taken it right at it. Shooting it up the gap, pushing. But, you know.
Now Daly from 200 yards, just a little 6-iron.
It's all right, Brian. It won't hurt him.
Tell that to my
two ex-wives.
You going to Memphis?
Funny enough, I was just about to mention he's won over $4 million in his career, but had a good time. And, of course, yeah. Fred and Mark are winners of $10 million plus, third and fourth all time. Freddie third, but just by a couple of thousand over Mark.
Go, honey. Go.
Caught it a little short, thick into the front bunker.
Short. Didn't come out like I thought it would.
Bunker? And then Saturday was winded out and cold. And then the next day,
yeah. How's the band been going? This didn't come out very solid.
Not a difficult bunker shot from there.
What's going on?
Well, we want to see what Mark O'Meara has used to facilitate these two majors victories out of the last three big tournaments, and we're going to get a little help from Jerry Higginbotham, his caddy, to describe what it is that makes Mark so special.
In the Bag, brought to you by Sprint Canada. Get the most for your business from Sprint Canada.
Hello, my name is Jerry, and I'm here at the Skins game this week, and I've had the opportunity to caddy for Mark O'Meara for about 5 years now. And we're talking about the 14 clubs and the golf bag that we're going to be using this week. And I think the putter is probably Mark's number one golf club. It was true this year at the Masters when he birdied three out of the last four holes. It was very evident last week at the British Open. The putter was definitely the club. And it is definitely the putter we use for all the cash.
There's what's in Mark's bag. TaylorMade 8-degree, tie two, bobble driver, three wood, 13-degree. And one through sand wedge, TaylorMade forged irons. Ping answer two putter, that's the one with all the magic in it.
So, Jim, if he's got a one, presumably he's got a two iron in there as well?
Yes, he does.
Then he doesn't carry a lot of wedges.
Is everybody okay?
No, just one sand wedge, one pitching wedge.
Sorry, very sorry. No, so sorry. Very, very sorry.
Very traditional.
That's okay. This rope's fine.
A bag of clubs for Amir. Hasn't gone to the L wedge.
At least I went out on a good note, anyways. You know what they say, though?
Yep.
The more you make, the more you spend. And it doesn't.
And this probably is an instance where he could use an L wedge, but
it's just sent it way up in the air.
You know, some guys just don't want to use the L wedge. They want to hit all the shots with one club, so they get very familiar with it. He's got to throw this straight up in the air. Oh, that was very good.
What's the big difference between an L wedge and, say, a sand wedge?
It's probably about 4 degrees of loft, so the L wedge is very useful around the greens.
Great shot.
John Daly's got one that's 64 degrees.
Shot, Mark.
You'd almost call it a double L wedge, and he's fabulous around the greens with it.
Someone stepped on my ball, sir.
Someone stepped on mine.
Just get you a good line, Mike.
Mike Weir's ball was kicked or stepped on, as he just said, by a
marshal. I've already moved mine.
That's good.
I kicked it.
We were reading the title.
Oh, my God. What a shot.
He heard somebody speak just before he took his backswing there. And
well, I think so.
That's exactly what happened.
To me, Mike.
Yeah, go ahead, Josh.
Even the best mess them every now and then.
You could chip this one in. I could chip it in, maybe.
Is there anyone out here?
Now, Daly from the bunker. Lots of green to work with, although it slopes away from him. Shouldn't have a problem stopping it.
They rolled a lot, didn't it?
Good shot, John. Hit it again.
Thanks. Yeah.
Rolled up and rolled down.
Good shot.
Well, it's not going to stay there now. Who's up here?
Just put it on the tee.
Sorry, Chris. No, it's all right.
White, please.
And that was Freddie's second chip.
I've known the three.
So he picks up for his par. Kind of an awkward lie here for Mike Weir. And thick.
Get in the hole.
Oh. Pretty aggressive there.
Good shot, Mike.
Thanks.
Shot, Mike.
I think it's Mike Weir qualified for the PGA Tour last year at the Q School. Six rounds of golf. The first round, he bogeyed the first four holes. And then he birdied 9, 11, 16, and 18 to get back to par on the first day.
And
that, he said, was just such a confidence boost to conquer that first four bogeys.
I have some excuse here. What do you think? I'd ask you which way, but I know you're probably working for the other team. Good call.
Mirror now with the 12-footer. Ball should break a little to his left.
So they break down. Knock it in,
all right, partner.
Buddy, pal. So it breaks down.
Well, so if you push it, it'll come back, right?
Well,
I like that. Tunnel vision.
$30,000 on the line on this third hole. O'Meara is in, so Mike will try the tie and force the carry. Nicely done, Mike Weir.
Nice four.
Thanks.
All right, JD.
I didn't hit.
For charity?
So that means it will be $15,000 added to $45,000 when we play hole number four coming up in just a moment. It's the Export A Skins game. Daily couples Weir and O'Meara. Be continued after this time. One of North America's great vacation destinations, PEI, and in the heart of Charlottetown is Province House. Fathers of Confederation met here in 1864, led by Sir John A. Macdonald of Kingston. Unified PEI Nova Scotia and New Brunswick, Canada became a dominion in 1867, and it all started here, just up from the fourth hole at Crowbush, Jim.
Fourth hole, 379-yard par four. The feature off the tee is these four grass bunkers to the right, and they are very much in the driving areas. 245 yards to carry those, so it pinches in the drive quite a bit. That last bunker you see on the right is 295 yards from the tee, and the second shot's probably going to be nine irons or wedges, and the pin today right back here over that bunker.
You guys ready?
I'm ready. Somewhere in Canada, ball.
That is absolutely monster drive there. Freddie laughing over there.
I'm not sure that's in Canada.
It's been nice to be young and hit the ball so far. That's true. Don't tell anybody, though. Just keep that little secret.
1995 Canadian Open champion, Mark O'Meara.
Beautifully balanced swing. And that is not short either. That's probably 275.
There's one left.
Yeah. Give us a chance, will you?
Daly's tee shot, 303 yards. Looks like it's headed just a touch right. At that bunker, but I think it's a little bit short of that, Ronnie.
Jim, you played...
All right, lefty.
And we're commenting that even though it's a links course, maybe not so much in the traditional sense, that it's maintained very green, and we've had some rain, so there's not a lot of roll like you'd see on a typical course overseas.
No, not typically a links course. When they first built it, it was very hard and fast, but the grass has grown very plush. Plays more like a Nicklaus-type course. And that's all right. It's just in the rough. Won't be a problem.
I
have to bring it in over those bunkers.
And I'm telling you, the fairways are bowling out. Right?
Well, a big part of the celebration of every Export A Skins game is a gathering of celebrities and guests to play in the Pro-Ams. And there is Lloyd Eisler from Seaforth. And you know why Isabel Brasseur felt so secure when they were doing some of those overhead lifts. Look at the power in that swing. Mention Sir Johnny McDonald from Kingston. There's another pride and joy from the Ottawa Valley, Kirk Muller. Ross Rebliati had a huge following here, the Olympic gold medalist in snowboarding. He'll stick to slalom and snowboarding, not to golf, as you can see. There's our snowbird, Ann Murray. Let's sing this song.
And you thought all I could do was sing.
You guys having fun? Junior golfers? Start young, because it's really tough. I started 6 years ago, and look at me.
Dave McEachran.
Sorry, Fred is lucky he's not playing today.
There's Peter Mansbridge.
Very nice.
His team complained they had an anchor. Premier Pat Binns, thanks for the hospitality. And Bob Cole, oh baby!
Premier, thank you very, very much. Gift from the Premier. New putter, and he ain't getting it back.
Jeez, a Wayne Gretzky stick, and now that, Bob.
Kind of the thing is, it's the guys who are like 5 or 6 under playing Poppy Hill.
Yeah. $45,000 on the line now. We'll see if that good humor continues. I mean, this is 6 Skins games for you up here, Jim. I can't think of a gathering that seems this loose this early, because usually the first day you're just trying to get a little unglued ready.
They're really having some fun here.
Yeah, it's one round.
Some guys are Poppy Hills.
Everybody's loose.
And it's look, clean, and place, move at a club length. Well, see, that's what I was saying. How can you go from spyglass to now hard and fast? I mean, I know they're all hard and fast, but it doesn't make any sense to me.
He's talking about the AT&T tournament that will be played and finished right after the PGA.
Watson and Lumpy are tied at 10 under, and they're playing spyglass. But anybody that's 7, 6, 5 under playing Poppy Hills,
5-4-5.
I thought Watson was at...
Is that right in there, 5-4-5?
Watson's at Poppy. No, they're both a spyglass.
Are they really? I think Watson's a pop.
Oh, is he?
I'm pretty sure, because he's all jacked up, 5 par 5.
Wow.
I could be wrong, John. What do I know? God
you
darn.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get.
We don't have.
Can somebody hold their hand up about where Mike's ball is?
We got no shot either.
There you go.
Oh, okay, there's your man.
That's what I was just trying to get.
You're right on it? Right? Yeah, he's right on it.
Good. Pretty good. Thanks. Pin.
Yeah.
Really?
Nothing. I think it's probably you than me, Mike.
Okay.
Mike, and the big 64 degrees still have a 60. Yeah, I thought you had.
Yeah, you're gonna need to get marshals, get them all back there first.
They're just discussing the double L wedge there. John Daly saying, "Think Mike's got one of my 64 degree wedges."
Just off the green.
Yeah, that's awesome.
There's about 105 yards.
What do we got, John?
The stick.
Now you can see the flag just playing almost limp. Of course, almost defenseless against these guys.
That's good.
normal wind would be straight against the players on this hole. Without the wind, it really took a lot of those grass bunkers out of the way.
Might jump a little bit. It's right in between the sand.
Dan Keel is Mike's caddy, and Dan played on the Canadian Tour last year and has decided to take a year off to go out and just get a sense of what goes on the PGA Tour, and figures that will help maybe give him a perspective to get back at it.
Well, nice guy to have on the bag. You know, when you go out there for your first year on tour, you can have a guy that calms you down and knows the game. This will be sandwich for Mike.
I think he knows something about this course, where to drive it. Better angle over there.
Mirror now, right in between pitching wedge and sand wedge, going with a little soft pitching wedge.
Cut a little bit.
Yeah, had to take some off that pitching wedge.
Got my Wheaties today.
Try to go underneath it, but caught a little too much of it. Back rough there. She landed in the fringe and back into that first cut of the rough. Total.
As he said, teeing off a little too close to his Wheaties this morning. But Mark was zero in. Now here's Freddie.
97 yards for Freddie. Loft a sand wedge up there over the bunkers. Ooh. Mike Weir's looking pretty good right now.
I'm sure he's smiling.
Got John Daly left, and Daly has 75 yards and a good time for that 64-degree wedge that he has. But even that club, he's got to back off a little bit. So.
And he made the comment he didn't like where he was positioned either, so let's see if he can cope with it.
A little too to see. He had to really decelerate coming down through it. But, oh, beautiful play.
Get there, tell you the truth, huh? That lie.
Yeah, he's happy with that from there. John Daly, $15,000 already in his pocket. Mike Weir can smell $45,000, and JD will try and spoil it for him when we continue here on the fourth hole, the 1998 Export A Skins game on CBC Sports.
And field championship Saturday.
Still very little wind as we play the fourth hole here. Golfers will play the first nine holes on Monday and the second nine tomorrow. This is the first year, of course, we've played this in prime time. The PGA Tour saying they didn't care to have their stars playing in competitions away from the PGA Tour, so that's why Monday, Tuesday format this year.
Huh? Oh, Mike? I don't know. Thanks. I don't know who it is.
Mark O'Meara now from the first cut of the rough. The ball sits down in this rough. It's very thick grass, but it sits down. Hard to get the club on it properly. He caught a little bit more of it than he wanted to.
Mark, who is it? Just you, JD.
All right, man.
Another guy that wastes no time once he gets on the green. Same kind of rhythm in this putting stroke as he has in his swing, long and flowing.
Shoved it.
Well, opportunity for Mike.
Nice block.
And the crowd smelling it.
John was just being nice to the rookie. He was
getting
a chance at it.
But the choke break just a touch to Mike's left. Maybe right edge putt. Mike's got a beautiful putting stroke. All right.
Well done, Mike. Mike's hovering around 170th on the tour in money won this year. And that's about what he's earned. So that's a happy $45,000. Man, you're talking to Steve Armitage.
Let's go. Great.
Thank you, Ron. Mike, congratulations. Your first skin in your first skins game.
Yeah, it's exciting. It's nice to get the monkey off the back pretty early, and nice three-hole carryover, so it's fun. I'm having a great time.
This is a loose group.
Yeah, it's making it real easy on me, you know, being out here with these guys. And I'm having a great time. It's a lot of fun.
Got to ask you, though, how intimidating is it to see Daly bust one 303 yards?
Yeah, if you try to hit it out there with him, you're going to be spraying it all over the place. You just got to kind of stick your game. But, man, he's got a great swing, great rhythm, and he just bombs it. It's fun.
Put that $45,000 somewhere.
Yeah. My wife will take care of it somehow.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Steve.
Ron?
Thanks very much. There's a look at Mike's $45,000 effort.
In the heart. Boy, you can't imagine how good that feels.
Jim, how would you say Mike's been received on the PGA Tour this year? Do people speak highly when they analyze his game and his prospects?
Yes, I think so. A lot of the top players look at Mike and say, you know, he's got the right amount of fire in his belly. You know, he pushes himself. He strikes the ball well. There's no glaring weaknesses at all in his game. And it's just going to take a little while for Mike to learn the golf courses and get comfortable out there. And that putt right there, you just can't imagine what it means to a guy to get on the board in this kind of a game and say, I belong.
Nick Price been here four times and come away with $10,000, shut out three times. So you're right, that's got to be a confidence boost. And now the fifth hole, and this is a tricky, this is where the course really begins.
Well, a 603-yard par five, and it's 250 yards to hit it over this bunker right here. So for these guys, hit it long, really not anything more than an aiming bunker. Daly and Couples may drive it out in the area where they can get it to the green in two, but I think right here in this area is where Weir and O'Meara will lay up. That'll leave them about 120 yards to the pin. The pin today is cut over here on this left edge of the green, right in here. So if guys are going at it with the three wood, like Couples and Daly might, it'll bring these trees in the back into play.
I don't want any part of him. Get Norman or somebody. We don't want the birdie machine.
What? When the wind sweeps off the sea, this is a monster hole. And there's the ocean in behind. You can see Gulf of St. Lawrence.
Beautifully done there, right down the middle. It'll be fun to watch the confidence grow. Now, Daly's target is really right at the clubhouse. Left side shouldn't be a problem. It shouldn't have reached the rough. Not exactly the swing he wanted, but if Mark misses it, he misses it a little bit left. Freddy wanting to get the angle. Teeing it up on the left side of the tee box. Ball headed a little right over that bunker and into the right rough. That will probably negate his chances going for it, too.
Me or you guys want to go
2 hours southwest of Toronto, in the border of Michigan.
Oh.
Well, now you know where Brakes Grove is located.
I remember
Nicholas had a key putt last year at Whistler, and Freddie was asking Greg Norman about the redwoods in California, so I'm not sure if he's here to win all that money or to sightsee. Goodness knows he's won a lot, never been shut out in his five previous appearances. Back to fewest dollars ever won, $50,000 last year. Freddie, though, is the king of the Eagles, second on the tour this year. He'll try and zero in from the rough here on hole number five when we continue. Nick Faldo, Greg Norman, big fly fisherman. So is Mark O'Meara, the Open and Masters champion. Don't know if he's tried his luck at this, but when you come to PEI, the commercial fishermen here run deep sea fishing tours for tourists. 3-hour tour, up to 16 people can get on the boat and try their luck in search of the plentiful cod.
Wow.
You can't find nicer beaches in all the world. Cavendish, world renowned, of course, but miles and miles of coastline just like that. Crowbush is located about 35 minutes out of Charlottetown, right on the edge of Almaketa, former great NHLer's hometown of Morrell.
This says 180 at the edge of the water. What?
Fifth hole. $15,000 will be the payoff at the end of this for the winner. Just waiting to see who's away. Fred Couples.
Actually, they just move. I'll hit right up over them.
Low runner.
I'm sitting here wondering, is there any human possible way to get home?
Well,
300. I hit it the other day, Saturday. I was right by this exact right side of that little.
How did it get over here? Huh?
Okay.
What do you got from the back?
Actually,
it
doesn't matter.
Front right?
Make sure you get the driver.
Okay. Get the birdie.
All right.
Bird's well, high.
Freddie in a position where he can't get it over the water. The ball seems to be sitting fairly well.
Back up just a little, please.
You would just Thank have you. To kill it.
Where are we going? At the building, or?
Yeah, you'll maybe just a hair left of the building.
With what?
You get 225 down the end, so you know what anything.
You gotta get it over these people, huh?
That's the first order of the day. Get it over all these people. they tend to stop the flight of the ball a little bit, you know, it's getting detrimental to your game.
Well, he's got good people skills.
Back in play. Now Mark O'Meara, 4-iron. Yep, perfect layup right down there by Freddie's ball.
Might as well get a driver and get it to
Good, Jenny. Take it deep.
John Daly is hitting third in this group, which means that Mike Weir has outdriven Long John by about 3 yards. Daly is hitting his driver, guys.
Now that was a mighty lash.
Through the water?
Huh? I hit it pretty good, though.
Huh? Just flat? Trying to hit it right, a little more right than
that. Well, Mike Weir has just taken out 6-iron. Just trying to get it down there, 120 yards or so from the pin.
Thanks.
What is this mean? That's where they thought they were going to hit a drive.
And those three all in the same area.
He's in the soup. We went for it. Came up just short.
So three nice layups and John Daly a little laid up here on the fifth hole. Continue our coverage of the Export A Skins game presented by NEC on the CBC after this.
Brought to you by Sprint Canada. Get the most for your business from Sprint Canada.
Hi, my name is Dan, a caddy for Mike Weir. A little something different that Mike has in his bag compared to most tour players is a 5-wood. 225 to 235 gives us a little more height coming into the green, gives us a better chance of holding the green. I played the Canadian Tour for 3 years with Mike. We played here at Crowbush in 94, and we're looking forward to coming back Monday and Tuesday and making some money.
Here's what's in Mike's bag. Callaway Big Bertha, 8-degree, 3-wood, or Lamar that he can just kill in that Callaway 5-wood. 3-wood pitching wedge, Wilson Progressive, and two other wedges, a 56 and a 60-degree. The Titleist Scotty Cameron putter that worked rather well last hole.
Knock a 7 down a little bit.
Knock down 7.
Yeah, Mike has 160 yards here. Probably laid it back a little bit more than he wanted to. You can get it right up to the water's edge and have about 115, 120 yards. But when he gets it going, he can really flag it.
Hello. There it is.
Beautiful gond above 12, 13 feet from Mike Weir.
What we got, George? Nice shot.
8 iron?
Thanks, Fred.
Ooh, the window thing. I've been over on every hole. We'll keep it down. Why? All right. Just a good one of these, huh?
140 yards for Mark O'Meara. Wind a little bit in his face. It's got to be an 8-iron. That one in.
26.
Good shot, Mark.
Yards for couples. Just a little baby 9-iron. Breeze just strong enough to keep him from hitting wedge.
Come off that hill.
So three putts at birdies. It's a long way in there, close.
To kind of stabilize.
Mark said he had 8-iron.
So we're trying to come up with drills.
Are you lifting too a little bit?
I haven't. Been.
Here's Mark O'Meara. You see his setup very well balanced right here. Arms hanging straight down. Watch this takeaway perfectly online in really a good position right here. Everything right online. That club, perfect position here. A good body rotation through the shot. And that's as solid as it gets. And watch the rhythm of this swing. Boy, nice flat feet through the swing. Doesn't get much prettier than that.
See, Mike Weir tapping that great mind. They played at the Kemper together, and he said one of the nicest bits of advice he got through the year was from Mark O'Meara, who told him he had absolutely all the tools to win out there and to be patient. Don't expect to have to do it this year or even the next. John's just charging. He's just a little aggressive, but that's the way he's got to be. And he knows the other three are in position.
That would have been John's fourth shot. One shot penalty, bringing it out of the lake.
Mark O'Meara rebuilt his swing again in 1994, like Faldo did with Ledford. He went to Hank Haney, his instructor, and maybe tell us, Jim, what he did to just reconstruct things.
Well, you know, when Mark first came out on the tour, he had a very long, loose swing and was prone to hitting some hooks. And even with wedge shots, his club was past parallel. And so he shortened the swing up, tightened it up, and actually started coming a little bit more from the inside on the downswing, and then holds the club with his body. And there are a lot of guys on tour who say they'd love to watch Mark O'Meara hit balls all day long. The beautiful rhythm, the great body rotation, never gets out of balance.
I think so. I want to see what you nailed. Gimme.
This was going to heal the damn drive.
This guy. Buffer.
Mark, give him a little heat there. Mike Weir's away. Well, he can put the pressure on these guys. Knock this one in. A little downhill.
Thanks.
Try, Mike.
Thanks.
Joey?
Good effort.
Great little hockey player. A left-hander and a Canadian.
Way up.
Mike Weir showing us he belongs.
Red's putt right underneath the hole. Really doesn't break much from here. I think he'll want to read some.
Yeah, a little light green.
Yeah.
Some break a little bit to the left, but it doesn't want to turn too much.
It's a birdie putt, though. It's been a half hour since I even had to bend down.
Freddie cheered himself on. He's finally got a birdie putt.
Joel Kevin, Freddie working together on the putt. John Daly doesn't use his caddy Brian Alexander at all on putts. They talk a lot on club selection on the hole, but 95% of all putts, Daly just does it by himself.
It's good luck at the cross-handed grip. Freddy's.
That's harsh.
Unbelievable. Well, always had it a little bit high.
Well,
they were thinking right edge, and it did hit the right edge.
How do these greens roll in terms of speed?
They're probably around 9 on the stimp. They're not fast. A lot of grass on the greens. A little bit grainy, but certainly a speed that you can be aggressive with.
$15,000. Quite the master celebration, but I'm sure Mark's happy to get that. Steve?
Mark, your first skin, Canadian skin. Congratulations.
Well, it's nice to get over that hurdle. You want to get those zeros off the board as soon as possible. Mike made a great birdie on the last hole, and I'm pleased with my birdie here.
You haven't played since the British Open. Do you feel like you're peeling off any sort of rust?
Yeah, a little bit. I actually played 9 holes on Saturday afternoon down with Tiger, and I knew I was a little bit rusty, but last week at Royal Birkdale was in a dream come true for Mark O'Meara. So I was trying to go home and savor the moment a little bit. And it's nice to come up to Canada this week. It's incredible, the gallery that's come out to watch us four play. It's just phenomenal. The weather's beautiful. Great to be here.
And you guys are having fun?
We are having a good time. Four good guys, you know, 3 of my buddies playing with them. And, you know, I played with Mike a couple times this year on the PGA Tour. He's a wonderful player. And it's just a matter of before he breaks through, and I think he's going to do it.
Mark, congratulations.
Thanks very much.
Ron?
Thanks a lot, Steve. And there's that sweet stroke of O'Meara's for $15,000. So we have one $15,000 hole still to play, and that will be the 6th. That's coming up next. Fred Couples has won $750,000 up here in Canada at this event.
Alfred's got his work cut out for him as we continue with our coverage from the links at Crowbush Cove in Prince Edward Island. Back at Crowbush, Fred Couples waits for his ship to come in. The other three and Freddie will have a shot at more than just the money on the par 3 sixth hole here at Crowbush. There you see the totals thus far at 184 yards from the tee.
Well, it's a neat little par 3. Ron, mid to long iron for a lot of players. You see this marsh runs diagonally in front of the green and right up the left edge. Bunkers right and behind the green. And this ridge you can see very well right here. Runs across this green, and the pin is tucked right in here. And so that ridge will be a very big part of this shot. If you catch the back edge of it, it'll shoot it off to the back edge of the green. You land before it, it'll stay in front. So a real tough little pin right here.
And it's more than the 15,000, Jim, up for grabs. As I say, this is the hole-in-one opportunity. Any of the four golfers sinks a hole-in-one, he'll win the all-new BMW 3 Series sedan. Doesn't she look pretty sitting there to think about?
Mm-hmm. Ready? 198. Sure. Let's try to hold it up against the wind.
Mark defeated Brian Watts in that dramatic four-hole playoff at Royal Birkdale, and he's a huge fan of that format. He thinks that's the perfect way to decide a major event. You still get it done on the Sunday, but you don't have it winner take all. You've got a chance to maybe catch up if you do get behind after one.
I agree wholeheartedly. Four iron for Amira. Wind blowing left to right.
Push it, wind. Push it, little wind. Push it.
Yeah, that's what a British Open champ is supposed to do.
Come on. Hey, he's got one. You both good. Hey, get lucky every so often. Oh, yeah. Aim a little right and pull it.
No, you're just good.
Oh, my God.
It's going a little bit left to right, huh?
Yeah.
I'm in between. I'm going to be around.
A little bit tougher shot for Mike, who likes to draw the ball. If anything, he's got to cut it back against this wind. Great view of the hole right there. This is the angle the players see.
And then cut. It's off.
John Daly going with six iron.
Yeah! Turnover.
That ain't even there, is it?
Yeah.
I just didn't hit it. So
got that ridge. Sits over on the wrong side of it.
Oh, that was gross.
Now Freddie going with the five iron. By no means an easy pin here. That is one fabulous shot that O'Meara hit.
Come left, baby.
Oh, Couples right beside Daly.
Trying to hook it in the slot. Damn gut gets in the way. Maybe that's what.
Mark O'Meara, he's had the stage now for the better part of the last 4 months, and here on the sixth hole, part three, clearly has it again. We'll continue the Export A Skins game. Crowbush, and you're looking at that world-famous Confederation Bridge, which connects Prince Edward Island to mainland Canada. That's, by the way, a little over $35. I just had the pleasure of driving across 3 weeks ago. As you can see, it's a spectacular view from the island, and if you're on the bridge itself, a little advice, it's better in a
a half ton or something that's tall enough to be able to see over the concrete sidewalls. If you're in a low riding car, you don't have quite the great view. So get yourself seated up high and remember to bring $35 and you'll have the time of your life.
What you did?
Sit out on the beach there?
Well,
you won this.
Yeah,
thanks,
if I was playing well, I'd rather be in Memphis. But you're going to caddy for Davis, so I'm not going.
You're a two-timer. You know that? All the money you make?
Love, man.
You know, he caddies for Justin Leonard at the Kemper. And he caddies somewhere else for a guy and showed up Monday night at the U.S. Open when I played Monday.
I have Kirk Couch.
Yeah, and then before the British Open, he decided to get there, you know, whenever he wanted because he caddied the week before.
Yeah.
But in fairness to Joe, Freddie doesn't like to play.
I'm playing practice rounds with different caddies at major events. He thinks I'm kidding him, but when the end of the year comes and the Christmas card and I get a new loop there at Kapalua, I think he'll get the picture.
So you see, Fred enjoys being shut out at these things.
Wow.
Need some help?
Well, I don't even have a clue.
Huh?
It's going left and then right, is it not?
Just show me a good line, will you? Huh?
Good view. Showing that ridge. Freddie has to putt over, and it's a very difficult read.
Thank you.
Oh, made it.
I mean, you're not supposed to make a 50-footer. Tell me about it.
Oh, what did that ball do?
I went right. I don't know how to do that.
Wow. That's good. Take it away.
Rake it. Rake it.
What an effort.
That was too good of a line.
Yeah.
No. It was tracking that way.
Yeah. Well, Daly got a perfect read. But after all, it is a 50-footer.
No, that's right. I can't believe I straight that. No, I played it straight, though. It must be coming off this hill right here.
Did you get three, Freddie?
Yeah, that's good.
Good?
Yep. All right, get it close, guys.
Well, the practice round, Mike had a chance to putt to this hole a little bit. And this putt is unbelievably straight. A lot of putts are right around this hole.
That's in the hole. Where else can it go?
Won't let it break. I just want to read something into it. Thanks. Great effort.
That held all the way in the middle.
Yeah. All of them.
Looks like it breaks left, Mark.
Okay.
How much? That's the question.
I think you got to play right lip, don't you?
Yeah.
I think that's probably looking pretty good.
Huh?
I don't know.
Say what?
You make that, I'm going to kick your ass.
You got to throw me in that lake over there.
John Daly, the 1991 PGA Tour Rookie of the Year. Mark O'Meara won that distinction in 1981, 10 years before.
On the WrestleMania.
Oh, yeah.
Huh? Rodzilla.
Have they done that yet, Carl Malone?
Did he hurt you?
Yeah, they did it. Did they do it?
Huh? Oh, man, you're too strong for me.
Huh?
Yeah, they did it.
Who
Malone
won?
Lost. Rodman
did he?
Won. Yeah.
Did you see it?
No, but I heard that Rodman won. I didn't pay to watch that. But
this was that beautiful tee shot that set up the second in a row for Mark O'Meara. No easy task. The wind straight in his face,
as you said, Jim, horrible pin placement for a golfer looking for a birdie. And that's a little too much for John Daly to stomach. Good for John.
You okay here?
Two beautiful strokes. Add up to two. And another 15,000.
So Mike Weir continues to lead the way as we move to the seventh hole, and you see bump it up by $5,000, $20,000 at the Export A Skins game on the line after this. Welcome back to Prince Edward Island as we continue our coverage of the 1998 Export A Skins game. It's a different version of down to having some fun. Water's a little cold to be jumping into, and there, of course, four great golfers and their legion of fans. I assume it's a legion, because like the legion, a lot of branches.
Seventh hole, 392-yard par four. Fairly straight away off the tee. That body of water there, not really in play for these players. 215 yards to the front edge of the fairway, but it gets a little more narrow up here, right up in this area. That's about 250 off the tee. Guys will have to decide either driver or three wood. Driver will put them up in the neck there. And the pin today is cut right up on the front, right in this spot right here. So it is definitely a birdie hole today.
Big banana.
I need something healthy.
All right, Mark,
yes,
get your target, buddy.
You got it.
Slow it down a little.
Okay.
A little slider.
Good job, Mark.
Just another fairway. Yeah, just another fairway.
A weak slice. The worst in driving accuracy. The worst in driving accuracy.
You got way up there.
Oh, I'm telling you, man. Yeah. I drove it good.
I did something.
I had one
desert Memphis thing on there.
But he's tied for eighth on the tour in birdies, and he's seventh in scoring average, 69-80. Mark O'Bara.
Mike, we are going with the three wood. Thinks good play. Get it down there where he can have probably a wedge, even with this three wood. So he can crank this little Orlemar three wood. Oh, beautiful swing.
That's a pretty dramatic.
Oh. Right.
Yeah. Pretty dramatic takeaway in his practice. In his.
Yeah, he wants to get the club in a position that he feels like if he hits that position, he's going to make a good swing. Every once in a while, though, his right hip comes out of it a little bit quick, and that shot happens. Daly, not laying up. That is such great rotation through the ball. He is so limber.
Good angle, huh?
He's got to be the loosest guy out there next to this guy. Of course, we know about Freddie's back troubles the last few years, but
perfect.
Turn left rudder. Watch. Left rudder.
Yeah.
Wind was supposed to.
Well, fans of golf are awfully familiar with Mark O'Meara, John Daly, and Fred Couples, and even as Canadians, we're just getting to know this 28-year-old native of Sarnia and Brightsgrove, Ontario. Mike Weir, first year on the PGA Tour, and this is a little bit of the bloodline he brings to the game.
There's a smooth swinging left-hander coming soon to a PGA Tour stop near you. From Brightsgrove, Ontario, meet Mike Weir. Last year, Weir was the class of the Canadian Tour, winning early at the BC Tel Open and later adding a victory at the Canadian Masters to three runner-up finishes. The success earned Weir the Canadian Order of Merit and a trip to Q School for the PGA Tour.
Having gone through the qualifying, five previous times, and
never really, I have never gotten past the second stage, so just to get to the final stage and have an opportunity to get there was a step for me. That last day, you know, I was teetering on the bubble all day, in at one moment and then out, and the kind of way things unfolded on the last few holes, you know, hitting a great shot on 16 to a foot, and you know, playing the last two holes very solid. And then, you know, all week I hadn't looked at a scoreboard, didn't know where I really stood, but you kind of sensed that it was close. And until Donna told me I had my card, I had no idea.
Congratulations. It's pretty sure that you're going to get your player's card.
Yeah, it's really exciting. You know, it was a struggle all day today. I just kind of held my composure all day, and the last five holes, it was real tough, but I held it together.
It has been a long journey for him just to obtain his card. If you can imagine myself 9 months pregnant, jumping up and down, that's exactly how I felt. And I just had tears in my eyes. I was so happy for him.
Hi, Al. Hi. Hi.
Daughter Elle arrived just 10 days after Mike earned his tour card. For first-time parents Mike and Brescia, having a baby and a new job on tour are equally demanding.
That's difficult to find that balance, especially right now in my career, my first year being on the tour. And things haven't gone as well as I'd like, and I want to spend extra time on my game right now. And, you know, it's kind of a little give and take with my wife. She's got to understand that a little bit, and I have to understand her needs and our little girl's needs as well. So we have a lot of communication. We communicate well, and I am finding that balance, and it's a learning experience as well.
I think in any area of athleticism, obsessiveness definitely is one of the factors that makes a good player a good player. But generally speaking, I do demand a little bit of a balance, and we do get out and do other activities and have other hobbies.
Do you
want to
get messy?
What color do you want?
It was always difficult leaving my wife for you know, lengths of time, but now with a little daughter, you feel like you're missing certain aspects of her growing up, and you know, sometimes you lose your focus a little bit, but you really have to remember when you're out there to be, you know, focused on the tournament, and then when you get home, spend the time with them. So.
After attending Brigham Young University, the Weirs fell in love with Utah, settling in scenic Draper. It seems the perfect backdrop for big plans and lofty goals, which drive Weir's ambition.
Part of the dream was definitely to get my PGA Tour card and to be a full member of the PGA Tour, but right now I want to get out there, I want to get in contention to tournaments, I want to get in contention to win tournaments, and then after that, if I feel like I keep improving and get to where I think I can get to, I think I can, you know, be one of the better players out there.
Thank you. That's fine.
Mike Weir.
He
is the leader here on day number one with $45,000, and that came courtesy of this nifty little job on the fourth hole.
Still can't see.
Yeah, very confident putting stroke. And
yeah, I can't see.
When you get Mark O'Meara's endorsement as a player, that's pretty strong.
Freddie Couples hasn't had the chance to play with Mike yet until today, of course, and but he said Joe LaCava, his caddy, just raved about him when he saw the caddy play. Wasn't that something, the emotion of qualifying too? I mean,
oh, you could see it welling up. You know, that's so many years of work to get there and to finally have that chance. You know, Mike said it was very hard to calm down and get started on the PGA Tour. And it's easy to say be patient, but it's very difficult to actually do that. 8-iron from Mike, and that came out soft and to the left.
Bad lie.
Yeah, you can hear him say a terrible lie.
I can't believe it's trampled.
Huh? It's about 125, huh? 126 to win.
That's a little one. Little 3-4.
Can't win now.
3-4.
Okay.
Now O'Meara on a bit of a roll. Birdies at the last two holes. He's a strong finisher. He's coming in with a 9-iron.
I think he was saying 126. Keep it under the wind a little bit. I think he's dialing it in right about now.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks, John.
Now, Freddie, the light rough. Got to bring it in over the edge of that bunker.
Bye.
Slammed it up against the flag. Ah, bad break there.
Got all the way back and caught the swell.
Good luck, JD.
John Daly with a nice shot in there about 10 feet left.
Well, that's a good break.
Brady had it right on line. Maybe too good. I don't know if he'd have been able to spin that back coming out of the rough, Jim, or not.
Maybe not, but he put it up there nice and high and just rattles it off the flag.
So, Mark O'Meara with $30,000 and a shot at $20,000 here on the seventh hole, clearly in the driver's seat. The Masters and Open champion, having the year of his life, and suddenly in control here at Crowbush. We'll continue our coverage of the 1998 Export A Skins game after this.
I'm here with Michelle Poirier, Vice President of Export A. Michelle, this is one great golf course, isn't it?
It's a terrific course. The layout is challenging for all level of players, including the four pros this week. And what better backdrop could we wish for than the Gulf of St. Lawrence? Terrific course.
Export A again has attracted one of the premier fields in golf. Quite a foursome, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is. In an effort to provide the best possible competition, we make it a priority to invite the finest players in the world. We've been successful in the past and certainly again this year.
Tell me why Export A brought this event to PEI.
Well, 6 years ago when we started the Export A Skins game, we make it a priority to take it right across Canada. We've held the event now twice in Quebec, twice in Ontario. Last year we went to Whistler in British Columbia. So this year we wanted to take it to the Atlantic coast. And certainly PEI has the type of golf courses that can accommodate the 5,000 plus spectators here on location every day, and as well as all the requirements for the media.
Anything else you'd like to add?
Yes, I can't thank enough the people of Prince Edward Island. Their warm welcome and hospitality has really made this event a superb event. And I only hope that everyone is enjoying the tournament.
All right, thanks.
Thank you, Jim.
Go in.
Well, Freddie Couples making his birdie putt there, and I know Freddie would echo those sentiments. The folks here on PEI showing us such a wonderful 2 days thus far, and still, of course, more excited to come Tuesday. Way to go, Fred. Not going to let that Mark O'Meara run away with this thing. One Masters champ to another.
Right guy got it. All right, now.
Well, that was deserved. He rattled it off.
That's right.
Get a little chip in there. There you go. Mark O'Meara saying he deserved that three.
All right, partner, knock it in.
You got it.
For his third birdie in a row here. Mark on a nice little roll. This putt, probably just a little outside the right edge. Expect this to catch some hole.
Howdy, did.
You know there's no way John can make it. John ain't been putt all year. I haven't made them all.
No. Wow. All right, you're on the board there, Freddie.
Yeah.
Wow, his chip is dead straight.
Teachy.
I didn't think he'd go left. I thought it'd be dead straight.
So Fred Couples joins the gathering. Wow. With his first skin for $20,000, and let's go to Steve Armitage.
On the board.
Freddie is on the board.
Well, pretty tough out here today. I haven't had too many opportunities. Hit the flag there and end up chipping in, but we're all a little bit in our pocket, so now we'll see who can just win the biggest skin.
Compare this group to Canadian skins groups in the past.
Oh, this is a riot. Obviously, it's fun to have Mike. The people are really pulling for Mike, as well as us. You know, make a long story short, I haven't seen much of him this year, and he's a great player, and I hope this gives him a little confidence, and wouldn't mind seeing him win. But this is a good field.
We've seen a lot of you. I'm sure we're going to see a lot more of you.
I hope. Now, at least I'm not hitting last. I get to hit first now. It's a better feeling.
Okay, Ron. Michelle Poirier, the vice president of Export A, Inc., whom you saw with Jim there a moment ago. Big Montreal Canadiens fan, and I'm sure he'd be thrilled to know that when Freddie Couples was on the Golf Channel last week, they asked him to wear a suit. He says, I won't wear a suit, but I'll wear something different. And he wore his Montreal Canadiens Patrick Roy sweater. He figured nobody'd know what was going on, but everybody was calling in, arguing hockey with him. So, Fred Couples, 20,000. Everybody's got a nice slice of the pie now, so they can all relax and go to the par 3, 214 yards.
Longest par 3 on the golf course, and usually plays straight into the wind, so a very intimidating hole. It's a large green, but you're usually hitting in 5-iron, so it's about 205 yards to get it over that lake right there. And there's a bailout area to the left, but today, with no wind, the players will be able to go right at the flag, which is cut right in that spot right there.
Absolutely glorious day. Temperature expected to hit 25 degrees this afternoon, so it's on the toasty side.
John, 202 on that eighth hole.
Really?
Yeah, nice.
Okay, I'm looking for a little help. That, thank you. That's my game.
Well, they really communicate, Joe and Fred. They really work out their distances.
Well, Freddie's picked out 5-iron. He's going to have to bust this to get it there.
Get out of here. Oh, God.
Good call, Jim.
Did you get all that?
Well, it's 8 days since I played, so.
Shoot, that's solid.
Good, yeah.
Yeah, the club face, you could see the impression of the ball dead center, so he hit it sweet. There's not enough club.
You just picked the wrong club. He got it over the lake, but it's in that long stuff in front of the green.
Send it out there. Be your friend.
Yeah.
Good, solid one.
It's really the hole you have to trust your yardage on, Ron, because it's over so much water. It's so deceiving. It's very hard to tell. You don't get much of a feel for how long it actually is. Think that Amir would have to go with 4-iron after seeing Couples. Boy, and he's short also.
Ah, he's in front of that one.
And let it get out to the right.
He did
go word that it was 5-iron. Trying to hit it hard, got a little ahead of it. So $20,000 on the line. Mike has a little bit of a feel for this hole.
What did he do when you played with him the other day? Do you recall on this?
No, we were playing, and the wind was howling straight against us, and it was the reason why he took his 2-iron out and put his 5-wood in the bag, and today, with not much wind, he's hitting 4-iron, but he thought he'd be hitting 5-wood.
Soft. Soft. Definitely there. Soft.
Daly's taking out 5-iron. That's a safe club for him.
Oh, beauty.
Beauty right there, JD.
Still in the hole.
That's good. Oh. That's going to hit 5 for sure.
Yeah, two smart plays after the Couples and O'Meara left it short of the green.
All right, thanks.
32-year-old John Daly. Seems like John's been on tour forever. Just came in like a hurricane. David Ledbetter said that's how he arrived, and he said his game spells danger wherever he plays. John Daly and Mike Weir will gun for $20,000 when we continue on hole number 8, the beautiful links at Crowbush Cove.
back, and just before we get to the putts on eight, John Daly in some of the greatest moments of his career, and we'll begin with the 14th hole at Atlanta Country Club, 330-yard par four.
Vintage John Daly just crushed it over the creek and almost makes one on that par four. St. Andrews. What a shot that was just to get it out. That is victory at the British Open.
This is the 1998 U.S. Open. Watch the reaction on the green.
You see, he hits it pretty straight, too, as well as being long.
Going for it. Right. I got a good line.
That's
man.
Not back there where left.
Left. Here
left.
Go left. I'm like,
dark. I hear you.
Huh?
I hear you.
Well, those 25
what's that?
Degrees
go in there.
Don't have such an impact down by the water.
That's true.
Good for Mark. It's going to get nice and warm and covered up.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
here, you want my gold chain?
Right?
I don't know
okay.
How much
more is left from that last hole.
There's a little Dennis Rodman in those
magazine.
Two.
What? Couple shot.
What?
Oh, he is in the water? This is made for TV stuff.
What a try. What a try.
Yeah.
Wow.
A little skin dipping.
Don't you love it, Joe? That took a lot of class.
Well, with that swing, Freddie must have caught a pretty good lie. Should be able to get it fairly close. Beautiful, Don.
Yeah.
That was a lie.
Yeah.
Pick it up. Pick it up.
Oh. Chipper, Fred. Okay.
So Daly and Weir with birdie putts.
I hit it hard, yeah.
Up.
Well, I mean.
Still hit a 215, Joey. I'm amazed.
Watch how fast John works. He says, Jack Nicklaus is his hero. He says he's the only player who played slowly that he likes. He patterned himself after players who played quick, except for the Golden Bear.
Oh, look out. Look out.
You can't find the edge any more than that. But
wow.
Bigger?
Yeah. Wow, wow, wow.
Good try there, JD. Good stroke.
It's hard to get yourself to play it to go left. But that last putt I had went so far left. Same line, you know. On that short one, I mean, it went dead left.
Mike Weir can add to his $45,000 right here.
Actually, a putt that doesn't break much. Actually, right down the fall line of the green.
Hey, Mike.
Hang it out there.
Good for you, Mike.
Thanks.
Joey.
Thanks.
I got you. Want need some help? Straight in.
Hang it out a little bit.
Your putt did nothing. It's not going to break across the cup, is it?
Was it in it?
Right in the heart.
Right on.
What's Daly got left? Mm-hmm. Oh, 2 feet, 3 feet?
No, it's a little bit longer than that. They both. Well, he's got a little more than 3 feet. They're missable. But you wouldn't expect two guys to miss from this range.
Oh, yanked the crap out of him.
Little D-cell.
Oh, my God.
Are you
smooth?
I pulled him.
So John Daly steals away that 20,000 from Mike Weir to make it a tie on the hole, and that'll be a carryover, making number nine worth $40,000. We have sat down with all four golfers and a little bit in the show today, and of course Tuesday evening we want to get some insights, and let's begin with Mark O'Meara, who captured the tournament of a lifetime in winning the Open at Royal Birkdale.
What transpired last week at Royal Birkdale at the Open Championship, to me, of all the championships, of the four major championships, that one sticks out, not because I just won last week, but that one has always stuck out in my mind as probably one of the top majors to win. Not to take anything away from my national championship, the U.S. Open, or from my Masters victory, but from the standpoint that the Open Championship is played on links golf, that's kind of where golf all got started. From the standpoint that the fans and the galleries are immense over there, and they're very, very knowledgeable about the game, not necessarily of a player having to hit a four iron from 190 or 200 yards to 3 feet, but sometimes it's just a nice recovery shot or a well-played bunker shot or a smart play on the golf course brings those fans to a tremendous arousal.
You know, when Brian Watts was in the bunker on the 18th hole and it looked like Mark was home and cool, he'd been told he could go in and watch it on television. He says, no, I'm going to go out and sit with Alicia and my kids. I'm going to enjoy the moment. And Watts looked to be in a really tough position in the bunker. He had a bad stance. Hits within a foot. And now you know, wow, that's maybe the fates are with this kid Watts. But O'Meara just looked so unflappable, didn't he, Jim?
He was. He mentioned to me that, you know, a calm came over him that he just couldn't explain. And,
yeah, yeah.
And, boy, it, as a player, you just wait for those types of moments to happen in your career, and especially in tough ones. Now look at the ninth hole, 367-yard dogleg right. A cluster of bunkers on the right side of the fairway, and one through the fairway will have to be avoided. The players can probably drive it over those bunkers. That's 267 yards to hit it over those bunkers. Daly may be able to actually get it in the area right here, right in front of the green. Pin today is cutting this back right shelf, right in the middle of this shelf, right in here. So guys will have to flop it up top, put some spin on it. But definitely a birdie hole for these guys.
Okay.
Playing a little bit downwind. So Freddie hits driver and hits it left of those bunkers. Set bunker through the fairway is definitely in play. It's about 280 yards off the tee. Open stance, left foot splayed wide open. Right underneath it, the right side.
That's in the other bunker?
Looked like it caught that last bunker.
Yeah.
That's not my shot. High cut.
Perfect. One iron wedge. I should ask Mike. He's played here.
Freddie's got the PGA to look forward to at Sahali, his hometown of Seattle, Washington.
Now Mira going with the one iron left of the bunkers.
Very nice.
Okay, Mark.
That's solid. Perfect.
I can scare a few people here myself.
Yeah.
Mike, we are going with the 5-wood. It's a lot of draws with this 5-wood, so he'll bring it up the left side of the fairway, and it's a good fit.
As we learned from Dan Keogh, his caddy, that 5-wood's the club in the bag that makes Mike.
That might be there.
Great ball, man.
Oh, look at this. The cheer on the tee was when Daly took out the driver. The guy swings it so long and so hard, he really does hit it straight. Just watch it come right out of it here. That is killed. That flew probably 300 yards and rolled another 25 or so. Here's a good look at his swing. A strong grip here, you'll notice. Right hand under a little bit, left hand on top. Left foot splayed out. Again, takes it way back inside and across the line here. But huge rotation. His back is actually pointed left of the target. And look where that club ends up. And watch those hips rotate through the shot. I mean, that is everything he has right there.
You could just hear the buzz in the gallery here at the links of Crowbush. Golf fans all around the world. Ever so thankfully earned his PGA Tour card, and the Daly became a weekend. 315, by the way, the distance. If that would have caught the downslope over in the rough, good chance he'd be on and one. Every man has money. $40,000 up for grabs at number nine next.
Sport A Skins Game on CBC. Brought to you by NEC Technologies. Expect more. Experience more. And by Sprint Canada. Get the most for your business from Sprint Canada.
Crowd assembling at the ninth green here at the links at Crowbush Cove.
Pretty solid night.
Pretty picture as 5,000 fans find a way to surround these four fine golfers.
So it's 270 that. I hit the 265.
Birdie's just going to level.
Small ledge up there.
What we got?
Mark O'Meara drove a 239.
Yeah.
He'll have 128 yards left.
Fine on our back. No breeze in the ability.
Mike Weir,
no,
262 on the drive.
No
play.
87.
Excuse me.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, they had it downwind off the tee a little bit, so
that
explains almost 240 yards with a one iron.
Who's first, Jeff?
97. Freddie was a little dismayed that his drive didn't carry those bunkers. He couldn't quite figure that out.
How much wind up there now? Still hit it,
it's still fun.
Okay, good solid one. Okay.
Got to be pitching wedge. And you can see his right back corner.
Hang it up there.
Hung his second shot to the right. He hung the 5-iron to the right on the 8th hole.
100 yards up, 6 behind.
Trying to force it just a little bit, I think. Two swings in a row.
It's cool, huh?
Yeah.
Mike Weir with 105 yards left. Sand wedge staring right down the throat of it. About a perfect yardage with a little bit of wind right behind him. Expect him to get this close. Great shot.
That could be right on the money.
Thanks, Mark.
6 or 7 feet left. Freddie Couples, not a good lie. Tried a couple stances, one with a foot in the bunker. Be lucky to get this up on that top level.
But you said, when you asked him, what's his best shot, he said, my trouble, getting out of trouble.
He's very inventive. But, yeah, he just had hit a perfect shot. Down on the bottom tier.
The grass would have gone through. It's like hitting into a wall. Oh, yeah.
John up there marking Freddie's ball. He's going to have to land this on the lower tier and bounce it
up to
the
top. Thanks.
Good
shot, Mike.
Actually, a tougher shot than Mike Weir had.
Just checked up a little on Daly, meaning it could be upping the check of Mike Weir. We'll see if he can roll in that seven-footer when we continue here on the ninth hole. 1998 Export A Skins game presented by NEC, and we'll continue from Prince Edward Island in a moment.
Export A Skins game on CBC. Brought to you by BMW, the ultimate driving experience. By Callaway Golf, how golf should feel. And by Investors Group, Canada's leading personal financial services company with offices from coast to coast.
Back at the ninth hole, Mike Weir in position here to try and capture 40,000 to go along with the 40,000, 45,000 he won on the fourth hole today.
Yeah, tell him my shot. Tell him what.
You can see Freddie. Just getting ready to let Mark O'Meara hit.
Yeah, just getting the feel down there. Mark O'Meara's got a bunker shot that he can make.
Pull it.
Good effort, but he knew he had to make it with Mike Weir in there 6-7 feet.
Fred Couples and Mark O'Meara were together at both the Masters and the British Open, a final day pairing at Augusta. And Freddie played with Mark on the Saturday at Royal Birkdale. Freddie was also with Justin Leonard at the Open for his victory the year before. And has a reputation of being a great player to be with when you're going for a title.
Scare in Mike Weir.
Ready?
Right. Okay.
Great effort. But went that way and stopped.
Yeah.
Great roll.
A little warble at the end, huh? Now, John Daly for his birdie.
His should break just a touch to his right. Oh, looks good. Mike Weir must be wearing Kevlar.
So dead right, huh?
Yeah.
I
I'd take O'Meara and Daly on the road if I were the PGA.
Got a problem. That's why I gave Hayden such a bad problem. Second shot.
No problem.
It's only for 40 grand, Mike.
What a heck of a thing to say to a rookie.
That's too funny. Those three have $24 million in their pocket. They won't give a rookie a break.
Just on the right edge and firm.
Yeah.
Oh! Oh, that way. Go that way?
Yeah, went that way.
Yeah, look like we see you in a while. Joey, I don't know where you're going.
Nice play to you. You have a chance, but
thank you.
Well, till Tuesday. $60,000 will be up for grabs when we go to the back nine tomorrow. There you see on day one, Mike Weir, all the same, $45,000. The best effort on the day. Mark O'Meara, Freddie Couples, and John Daly all getting at least a skin today. Let's go down to Steve Arnold.
Thank you, Ron. On that last putt, Mike, did you just misread it or just miss it?
I think I did misread it. I hit a great putt. Hit it nice and firm right in the center of the hole, what I wanted, and actually moved a little the other way. I thought it was dead straight.
JD and Freddie weren't helping at all.
No, they hit great putts. I thought both their putts were going in, so I hit a good putt. What can you do?
Mike, look ahead to the second nine, the back nine here at Crowbush.
Yeah, the back nine, I think we'll have a little more opportunity to make a few more birdies. There's a couple more par fives that we can get to, and you know, number five we weren't able to get to, so everybody will be able to get to the par fives out there, and maybe an eagle will win a skin tomorrow.
$45,000 in your jeans. You're going to have some confidence.
Yeah, you know, I struck it well. I played well. Yeah, I got a little confidence going into tomorrow, and got some money in the bank, so I got that monkey off my back that I've got a skin already, so I'll be looking forward to tomorrow.
Great job, Mike. Congratulations. Ron?
Thanks, fellas. Jim, I was extremely impressed with John Daly and what he brought to the table here today. We all knew we'd get a thrill out of seeing the Open and Masters champ, and I think he might have been a big part of why Mike Weir felt as good as he did and played as well as he did.
He really kind of set the stage. You know, yeah. He was loose and having fun and making sure everybody was kidding around, and got the skin right out of the blocks, and so it kept his kind of momentum that way, and it filtered over in everyone. Freddie Couples was just talking a blue streak right off the bat. So I think the most entertaining nine holes we've seen in the Skins games.
Well, obviously a day at the beach for these four. Take a break, come back to wrap our coverage of day number one, the 1998 Export A Skins game. Welcome back. Want to show you the shot of day number one, brought to you by Investors Group, Canada's leading personal financial services company. For this, we go to hole six in Mark O'Meara.
Against a crosswind, Mark O'Meara just fires a four iron about 8 feet from the hole. And this the putt for his birdie two.
Had one of his first skin for $15,000. He won another on the next hole, so $30,000 for Mark O'Meara. And what makes that shot so grand, and what makes John Daly take exception with a little belly bounce, is that nobody else could even get it close on that hole. And that's what we expected from the Open and Masters champ, and got it. And there you see the leaderboard after nine holes of competition. Brights Grove, Mike Weir, $45,000. Mark O'Meara gets the 30. Fred got on the board toward the end, and John Daly launched our coverage today with $15,000 captured on hole number one. The links at Crowbush Cove was rated by Golf Digest as one of the top 10 public golf courses in North America, and that's over 5,500 courses to choose from. And again, Score Magazine ranks it top 10. And Jim, she was picturesque, and I thought a little friendly today.
Yes, she was. Very little wind at all, just enough to keep the guys honest, and they really tore it up. And they made a lot of birdies, which is really fun in a skins game. The people loved it. The players were happy, jovial, and joking all day, and I think it was a fun day of golf.
There's no question about that, and we knew that
John Daly and Fred Boom Boom Couples have a knack for playing well to the gallery. Mark had to be loose. The question was, Mike Weir, when he got in this gathering, how would he feel? How would he play? And he's the leader after day one.
Exactly. You know, that was the question. How will he react? You know, these are all major winners, and will he fit in? And by the fourth hole, he was proving that he was going to fit in.
Let's just show you two big highlights for Mike, the $45,000 effort here on hole number four first, Jim.
He drove it into the left rough, but hit a beautiful wedge shot right behind the hole here. And that gave him this putt for the $45,000. No mistake there.
Then with $40,000 up for grabs on hole number nine, he launches this approach.
From 105 yards, a perfect sand wedge distance for Mike. And he nestles it in there close.
Now, to just show you how well accepted he is, listen as he lines up the putt to John Daly's words of wisdom.
It's only for 40 grand, Mike.
Right about that time, Mike Weir knows that he's accepted by the rest of the guys.
Yeah. They'd only kid you if they loved you. And they love this outcome, too. You made the point. You and he played together and both had that putt on number nine.
Yeah, he'd hit it a couple times in practice and forgot that it broke left. And he hit the putt he wanted to, but it broke left and he missed, and he left that money on the table.
Right. It wasn't that they bothered him. But they're really pleased, obviously, with the $60,000. And when you look ahead, $250,000 up. And one of the things that I've often said about this, as much as it's like a championship Sunday tomorrow, we'll see a few missed shots, too, because the golf cameras aren't just following the guys who are in contention or on a roll.
Right, we're not playing a tournament where after 72 holes you've played great and you're in the lead, and this is more of a fun event. Sometimes the concentration wavers just a little bit, but so you'll see a few wayward ones, but you'll see a lot of really aggressive shots. You know, John Daly taking out driver everywhere. It's fun to watch.
John Daly coming out of his shoes on nine. Maybe Greg Norman off the cart pass, the only shot that I've seen that maybe gave you that sense that it's no holes barred here.
Oh, he swings at it so hard, and when he swings at it hard, he hits it so straight. It is amazing to watch. I know Steve Armitage is out there in awe.
Yeah. Well, the forecast is calling for clouds and possibility of a shower later today, maybe some wind tomorrow. When we play those final nine for $250,000, we'll be showing it to you at 8:30 in Newfoundland, 8 in the Maritimes, 7 o'clock everywhere else in the nation. Till then, for all of us, hope you enjoyed the Seaside Rendezvous with four of the greatest in golf. So long for now.